Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn how to convert any decimal number into the binary equivalent number. Now in general, if we have some number in one particular number system, let's say a base B number system, then this is how we can find its decimal equivalent. For example, if we have some binary number, then this is how we can find its decimal equivalent. And in fact, in the previous video, we have already seen that. But now let us see, if we have given some decimal number, then how we can find its binary equivalent. So by successively dividing the decimal number by the factor of 2, we can easily find the binary equivalent. So first of all, in general, let us understand how it works. So let's say, there is some decimal number n, and we want to find its equivalent number in some base B number system. So if we divide that number by the factor of b, then the remainder is the least significant digit in that particular number system. So in this case, it is equal to x0. Let's say the remaining number is equal to n1. So if we further divide this n1 by the factor of b, then once again, this remainder is the next number. And in this case, it is equal to x1. Let's say this remaining number is equal to n2. So once again, if we divide this n2 by the factor of b, then the remainder is equal to x2, that is the next number. And now let's say this remaining number is equal to n3. So once again, if we divide this n3 by the factor of b, then we will get this x3, that is the most significant digit. So as you can see, by successively dividing this decimal number by the factor of b, we can find the equivalent number in the base B number system. Similarly, by successively dividing the decimal number by the factor of 2, we can find its binary equivalent number. So let us take one example and let us understand how it works. So let's say we want to find the binary equivalent of the decimal number 27. So first of all, let us divide this 27 by the factor of 2. So if we divide it, then the quotient will be equal to 13. And in this case, the remainder is equal to 1. So once again, if we divide this 13 by the factor of 2, then the quotient will be equal to 6. And in this case, the remainder is equal to 1. So once again, if we divide this 6 by the factor of 2, then the quotient will be equal to 3. And in this case, the remainder will be equal to 0. And still, since the number is more than 2, so once again, we can divide it by the 2. So if we divide it by the 2, then now the quotient will be equal to 1 and the remainder is also equal to 1. And now, since the number is less than 2, so we cannot divide it by the 2. So in this case, if we divide it by the 2, then the remainder is equal to 1. So that is the last remainder. So this last remainder is the MSB, while this first remainder is equal to LSB. So if we write it down all these reminders, from bottom to top, then we can get the binary equivalent of the decimal number, that is equal to 11011. So in this way, we can convert any decimal number into the binary equivalent. So let us take one more example so that it will get clear to you. So now, let us find the binary equivalent of the decimal number 112. So once again, let us start dividing this 112 by the factor of 2. So if we divide this 112 by the factor of 2, then the quotient will be equal to 56. And in this case, the remainder is equal to 0. So that is our LSB. So once again, if we divide this 56 by 2, then our quotient will be equal to 28. And once again, the remainder is 0. Now since the number is more than 2, so once again, we can divide it by the factor of 2. So now, after the division, the quotient will be equal to 14, and still the remainder is equal to 0. And once again, if we repeat this procedure, then the quotient will be equal to 0, and the remainder is still 0. And further, if we try to divide it by the factor of 2, then now the quotient is 3, and the remainder is equal to 1. And still, since the number is more than 2, so once again, we can divide it by the factor of 2. So after the division, now the quotient is equal to 1, and the remainder is also equal to 1. And now, since the number is less than 2, So if you try to divide it by the factor of 2, then the quotient will be equal to 0 and the remainder will be equal to 1. That is our MSB. So if we write the remainders from bottom to top, then we will get our binary equivalent of the number 112. So in this way, we can convert any decimal number into the binary equivalent number. So now, let us see if we have any decimal fraction, then how we can convert it into the binary equivalent number. So if we have any fractional decimal number, then by successively multiplying it by the factor of 2, it can be converted into the binary equivalent number. So to understand that, let us take the general example. So in general, if we have any fractional number in some number system, then this is how it can be converted into the decimal fractional number. For example, if we have any binary fractional number, then this is how it can be converted into the decimal equivalent number. So now, let us do exact opposite. So let's say we have some decimal fractional number f and we want to convert it into the equivalent fractional number in some base b number system. So if we multiply that decimal number by the factor of b, then this x minus 1 is the integer part, while this f1 will be the fractional part. So let us write down this integer part separately. And now, once again, let us multiply this f1 by the factor of b. So after the multiplication, this x minus 2 will be the integer part, while this remaining is the fractional part. So once again, let us write down this integer part. That is our second digit. And once again, let us multiply this fractional part by the factor of b. So after the multiplication, we will get this x minus 3. That is our third digit. And in this case, it is the integer number. So if we write down these integer numbers from top to bottom, then we will get the equivalent fractional number in some base b number system. So in this way, by successively multiplying the decimal fractional number by the factor of b, we can convert that decimal fractional into the equivalent number in some base b number system. Similarly, by successively multiplying the decimal fractional number by the factor of 2, we can convert it into the equivalent binary number. So based on that, let us take one example. So let's say we want to convert this fractional decimal number into the binary equivalent number. So first of all, let us multiply this number by the factor of 2. So after the multiplication, the number is 1.25. So here, this 1 is the integer part, while this 0.25 is the fractional part. So let us write down this integer part separately. And once again, let us multiply this fractional part by the factor of 2. So after the multiplication, the number is 0.5. So once again, here the integer part is 0, while the fractional part is equal to 0.5. So once again, let us multiply this 0.5 by the factor of 2. So after the multiplication, the number is 1. So now, the integer part is 1, while the fractional part is 0. And here, since the fractional part is 0, so no need to carry on this multiplication. So now, if we write down this integer part from top to bottom, then we will get our binary equivalent of the number 0.625, that is equal to 0.101. So in this way, we can convert any fractional decimal number into the binary equivalent number. Alright, so now let us take one example where the decimal number has both integer as well as the fractional part. So let's say we want to convert this 78.33 into the binary equivalent number. So first, let us consider only the integer part, that is equal to 78. So for the integer part, as we have seen, by successive division, we can find the binary equivalent number. So first of all, let us divide this 78 by 2. So after the division, the quotient will be equal to 39. And in this case, the remainder is equal to 0. Then after, if we divide this 39 by 2, then the quotient is equal to 19 and the remainder is equal to 1. Once again, if we divide this 19 by 2, then the quotient is equal to 9 and the remainder is equal to 1. And since the number is more than 2, so once again we can divide it by the factor of 2. So after the division, the quotient will be equal to 4 and the remainder is equal to 1. Once again, if we divide it by the factor of 2, then the quotient is equal to 2 and the remainder is equal to 0. And if we repeat the same procedure, then the next time the quotient is equal to 1 and the remainder is equal to 0. And now, since the number is less than 2, so the quotient is equal to 0 and the remainder is equal to 1. So if we write down all these remainders from bottom to top, then we will get the binary equivalent of the number 78. That is equal to 100110. Similarly, now let us convert the fractional part into the binary equivalent number. So now, the fractional part is equal to 0.33. So let us start multiplying it by 2. So after the multiplication, the number is equal to 0.66. And if we separate the integer and the fractional part, then here, the integer part is equal to 0, while the fractional part is equal to 0.66. So once again, let us multiply this fractional part by the factor of 2. So after the multiplication, the number is equal to 1.32. So here, the integer part is equal to 1, while the fractional part is equal to 0.32. And once again, now let us multiply this 0.32 by the factor of 2. So if we follow this procedure for a couple of times, then we will get the following integer numbers. And if we keep on doing it, then this multiplication will go on. So if you want to check, then you can pause the video and you can check by yourself. So here, as you can see, even after 5 to 6 multiplications, this fractional part is non-zero. So once we get these sufficient numbers, then we can stop this multiplication procedure and we can write it down these integer parts from top to bottom. That means the binary equivalent of this decimal fractional 0.33 is equal to 0.010010. And this is the binary equivalent of the overall number. So in this way, we can convert any decimal number into the binary equivalent number. And in general, if we want to convert any decimal number into the equivalent number in some base B number system, then by successively dividing that number by the factor of B, we can get the equivalent number. For example, if you want to convert this decimal number into the equivalent number in base 5 number system, then by successively dividing this number by the factor of 5, we can get the equivalent number. So on the second channel, we will see few examples based on this conversion. But I hope in this video, you understood how to convert any decimal number into the binary equivalent number. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.